There are some truly unbelievable places in this world, and none of them are quite as strange as these weird and wonderful borders. When one country meets another totally different country, well, there's bound to be some differences that stick out like a sore thumb. Yep, borders can be complicated, but sometimes they can lead to the most unusual and unique sights that exist on this planet. From the largest waterfall in the world that flows between two separate countries, to the islands that are just 4 kilometers but 20 hours apart. These are 15 of the world's strangest borders. You'll regret if you don't see them.
Victoria Falls, or as the locals call it, Mosiatunya. It means the smoke that thunders.
Indonesia and Malaysia. Welcome to the road to nowhere. Yep, this strange border shows the moment when the asphalt road simply stops in its tracks, transforming into a dusty dirt trail. Have you ever seen a border quite like this? Indonesia and Malaysia share both ocean and land borders, and there have been disputes over where it should begin and end for decades, dating all the way back to the 1960s. However, despite their differences, they've managed to keep the peace in both countries. The 1,881-kilometer land border runs through the island of Borneo, which is famous for its top-notch natural resources. And they also have maritime boundaries along the Straits of Malacca, the South China Sea, and the Celebes Sea. No one ever said drawing borders would be easy. Now on to our next strange border, where the military takes part in an epic dance-off every night at sundown. Hey, hey, did you know that if you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you're more likely to win the lottery? So what are you waiting for? Pakistan and India. This awesome ceremony has to be one of the most unusual events we've ever seen. Yep, every day as the sun sets on the Wagah Atari border between Pakistan and India, this incredible dance party takes place as a symbol of brotherhood and cooperation. Come on. What brings people together more than a good old-fashioned boogie? But these aren't your average dance moves. The lowering of the flags is performed by the border security forces of Pakistan and India, respectively. The military dance is famous for its high leg kicks and rapid movements, and ends with a perfectly timed lowering of the two nations' separate flags. For two countries with such a tense political history, this drill is an important moment that brings these neighbors together on a daily basis. In 2010, it was even decided that the more aggressive dance moves should be toned down so that the whole thing had a more peaceful vibe to it. Oh yeah, and did we mention that the guards have a strict mustache policy in which they're paid extra to grow some seriously impressive facial hair? That's right, these guys mean business. Hotel Arbez. Welcome to Hotel Arbez, the weird and wonderful place where you can actually go to sleep in two different countries. That's right, the honeymoon suite in this hotel is right on the France-Switzerland border, and the border runs right through the middle of the master bed. Who knew it was possible for your side of the bed to actually be in a whole different country? The dining room at this unusual hotel is also bisected by the border, so you can eat your dinner in Switzerland and then head over to the bar in France. One staircase is even French at the bottom and Swiss at the top. We're not sure how that even makes sense. This anomaly of a hotel is all thanks to the handiwork of a local businessman who bought up the land over 100 years ago, knowing that a border was about to be built right through it. He hoped he would be able to make some cold hard cash by capitalizing on cross-border trade in alcohol, tobacco, and chocolate, and constructed the building in order to begin his empire. Later, in 1921, hotelier Jules John Arbez bought it from the original owner's heirs and created the International Hotel Arbez that we know and love today. Can't decide between a vacation in France or Switzerland? Well, now you don't have to. It really is the best of both worlds. Victoria Falls. Located right on the border between Zambia and Zimbabwe, Victoria Falls is one of the world's largest waterfalls. At 5,604 feet wide and 354 feet tall, this is the biggest sheet of falling water on the planet. In the local Sotho language, the falls are called Mosiatunya, which translates to the smoke that thunders. This epic waterfall is twice the size of North America's Niagara Falls, attracting hundreds of thousands of visitors each year. And you can even cross between the borders to get a good view from both sides. as long as you purchase the correct visas, of course. We're not sure there's anywhere else in the globe where you can see people bungee jump over a roaring waterfall while you apply for a visa, but let's face it, this is no ordinary border crossing. Playas de Tijuana. Even the ocean has borders. The 18-foot high border fence on the Playas de Tijuana extends out 300 feet along the beach and into the waves, separating Mexico from the United States. Yep, there's no swimming into this next country on the beach. The fence is made from iron bars and was erected by the US government to try and tackle immigration. But marine experts are warning that this metal barrier is costly and dangerous to local wildlife. There's no doubt about it, the Playas de Tijuana barrier is controversial. This beach might be divided, but it's also a spot where loved ones and friends separated by the border meet up to hang out and hug through the fence. This may seem like an unusual day at the beach, but for some people, it's just the everyday reality of living in a totally different country to your family and friends, yet still being within arm's reach. 4,000 Islands. At the foot of the Laos and Cambodian border in Southeast Asia, there's a real island paradise that you can only get to via a long and exhausting bus trip. Yet most tourists avoid the charming and isolated 4,000 Islands, and they're missing out. Clusters of tiny islands, some of them too small even for roads or houses, are scattered throughout the Mekong Delta, creating a charming island paradise that's completely unspoiled. Also known as the Siphon Dawn in the Lao language, you can spot rare and endangered Irrawaddy dolphins swimming in crystal clear waters, and spy gentle water buffalo living undisturbed here at the 4,000 Islands. If only all borders were as peaceful as this one, the world would be a much better place. The Northwest Angle. This small U.S. town is officially the most northern part of Minnesota. However, thanks to an awkward surveying error back in the early days of the United States of America, the Northwest Angle is actually bordered by Canada on each side. Yep, to get to this quirky remote U.S. town, you actually have to cross the Canada-U.S. border twice, once heading into Manitoba in the west and then back into Minnesota in the south. Located on the edge of the Lake of the Woods, if you want to legally cross the border, the only way to do so is by finding an unmanned, unheated shack called Jim's Corner, where you can call up a border agent by video phone and register your arrival in the country. However, with a spotty signal and unreliable technology, this is not always an easy task. If you're visiting your loved ones in the Northwest Angle, don't forget to bring your passport, because you're gonna be crossing the border at least twice. Iguazu Falls. Go big or go home. On the border of the Argentine province of Misiones in the Brazilian state of Paraná, the legendary Iguazu Falls is the largest waterfall system in the world. This incredible South American waterfall is a whopping 269 feet tall, dwarfing every other waterfall in the world. Iguazu literally translates to big water. We can't think of a more breathtaking border in the world. Iguazu was home to 275 individual waterfalls as well as ethereal floating islands that look as though they belong in an epic fantasy movie. If you're on a South American road trip, you cannot miss this world-famous landmark. We're officially adding the mind-blowing Iguazu Falls to our bucket list. Ban Giac Dedian Waterfall. If you visit the Chinese-Vietnamese border, you'll find the magnificent Ban Giac Dedian Falls, the largest waterfall in all of Asia. Torrents of water cascade down the side of a three-tiered cliff. It may only be the fourth largest waterfall in the world at 656 feet, situated in Daxin County on the Chinese side and Trung Khan County on the Vietnamese side. Anyone traveling through Asia should definitely check out this awe-inspiring natural wonder. You won't regret it. Peño de Vélez de la Gomera. This tiny peninsula between Spain and Morocco is one of the shortest land borders in the world. In fact, this 280-foot line on the beach didn't even exist until 1934, when a huge storm dumped a whole heap of sand on the coast of Peño de Vélez de la Gomera, connecting it to Africa for the first time. It just goes to show that you never know what Mother Nature might bring right to your doorstep. Now, this place is home to a Spanish military base, and just a couple of hundred feet of plastic cord separates it from nearby Morocco. Who knew that you could travel from Europe to Africa in just a couple of footsteps? Spain to Portugal zipline. This 2,360-foot zipline is like no other. Not only is it a huge adrenaline rush, but you also cross a border and a time zone. Not bad for a thrill ride that lasts less than a minute. Englishman David Jarman built this epic zipline between Spain and Portugal, saying two villages in two countries. Separated by a river 150 meters wide, a zipline just seemed obvious to me. Well, duh. The opportunity to build the only zipline in the world that takes its passengers over an international border is just way too good to pass up. This one-of-a-kind zipline carries an average of 25 people an hour when it's busy, costing just 15 euros for a ride. That's a small price to pay to be able to boast that you ziplined over the Spanish border. The steel cable passes right over the Guadiana River at a speedy 80 kilometers an hour from Sanlúcar de Guadiana down into the Portuguese town of Alcoutim. And when you land on the other side, you'll find yourself a whole hour ahead, thanks to the time difference. Time flies when you're having fun. The Diomede Islands. Also known as the Yesterday and Tomorrow Islands, the Diomedes are the closest non-border sharing country to the United States. Located in the middle of the Bering Strait between mainland Alaska and Siberia, Big Diomede is in Russia and Little Diomede is in the United States. Only 3.8 kilometers of water separates the two. Despite the short distance between them, they're a whopping 20 hours apart, thanks to the invisible international dateline that runs between the two. How crazy is that? This mind-blowing time difference is the reason they're known as Yesterday and Tomorrow Islands, since theoretically you could be on one island where it's a Sunday and then cross over to the next where it's already Monday. The passage between the two islands is also known as the Ice Curtain, partly due with the Cold War tensions between the two countries, but also due to the fact that during the winter it's sometimes possible, however strictly forbidden, to walk over the ice from the US and into Russia. That is one strange border. The Barlinnassau vs. Barlinnhertog. This geopolitical anomaly is totally mind-blowing. The Dutch town of Barlinnassau, there are nearly 30 Belgian enclaves known as the Barlinnhertog. But what does that mean exactly? Well, to put it simply, small pockets of this Dutch town in the Netherlands are actually Belgian. It all dates back to the Middle Ages, when parts of the land were divided up between different aristocratic families, leading to a whole lot of confusion over who owned what and where. Today, you can actually see the border lines on the sidewalk, helpfully informing people which bits are Dutch and which bits are Belgian. Thank goodness for that. Some houses even have a little flag of the country they belong to on their door, so you can tell where you are. But living in two different countries in one town has its complications, to say the least. For example, the legal drinking age in the Netherlands is 18, but in Belgium, you can purchase alcohol at the age of 16. Meaning if one bar turns you away in town, teenagers can simply cross the road and get served in a Belgian bar. And then you have the matter of fireworks, which are illegal in the Dutch parts of town, but can be bought in the Belgian shops, creating all manner of chaos when it comes to celebrations like New Year's. It's all part of this unusual town's quirky charm, we suppose. Poland-Ukraine land art. This has to be the only border in the world where a giant crop circle lies in between two nations. We are, of course, talking about this huge fish that has washed up right between Poland and Ukraine. But this isn't the work of aliens or flying saucers. No, this gigantic work of art was created by the artist Jarosław Kozjara for the Land Art Festival as a symbol of unity and trade between the two countries. Constructed back in 2011, this massive crop circle certainly got everyone talking. The artist sowed at least 23 different kinds of plants to create the living sculpture, turning an otherwise boring border crossing into a green and vibrant masterpiece. Why can't all the borders look as epic as this? Khanjarab Pass. This treacherous mountain pass is located on the northern border of Pakistan and China and is notorious for being the highest border crossing in the whole world. Yup, the Conjurad Pass is a whopping 15,528 feet above sea level, and during the winter season, it's completely covered in thick, impassable snow, making it nearly impossible to cross the border. Not only is it typically shut between November 30th and May 1st, but traveling here is no picnic for the rest of the year either. That's because its sheer height causes altitude sickness, extreme weather conditions, and the steep roads are a real nightmare to navigate. And then, once you do make it across the Conjurad Pass alive, you must remember to switch from driving on the left in Pakistan to on the right in China. Yeah, you definitely don't want to forget something important like that. Despite its drawbacks, we bet the whole thing is a pretty awesome adventure. And you can even say you've drawn cash out from the highest ATM in the world as well. Every cloud has its silver lining, and there's a lot of clouds up here. Well, there we have it. Humans have been creating borders for thousands of years, and sometimes they're in the most peculiar places. So which one of these strange borders would you most like to see? You can let us know in the comment section below. And don't forget to give us a big thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. You can also hit subscribe for more awesome Missing Files content. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.